Now onto an investing session. Nearly 1 million divorces happen every year. It's both emotionally and financially stressful. For money advice, we are turning to Meredith Stoddard, who's with Fidelity Investments. You took a survey, Meredith, and what are investors telling you?
People know that a divorce is going to be hard, but what we're finding is that people often felt very unprepared, especially in the beginning phases, for not only the financial aspects of it, but the emotional aspects. We also found that 75% of people kind of winged it and figured it out as they went along, and that actually made it a lot harder to get through it and figure out where you were going and what lies ahead. The other piece is that the little things can trip you up. The sentimental items, the pets can really be daunting and slow things down. But the good news is that as people get through it, the financial, the emotional get a lot easier, and most people do fully recover on the other side of this.
What should people do?
It's important for people to remember that they don't have to figure this all out at once. It can take, on average, over 10 months to go through the divorce process, so there can be this immense overwhelming feeling of just needing to do it all now. So that first step, as I mentioned, documenting everything and just figuring out what are your debts, and then what might a reasonable outcome be. So you can't get to the reasonable outcome without having a sense of where you are, so just getting that down on paper and having support to get you through that is going to make a really big difference in taking the daunting and making it seem manageable.
What are some of the mistakes that you see investors making?
What we were told by people that they regretted as they went through the other side of the divorce is that they wish they had been more involved in the finances. They wish that they had kept their emotions at bay, which I know is a lot easier said than done, and they wish that they had enlisted a lot more help as to get them through this. Some tips around getting more involved is just about getting started and documenting where are your credit cards, what's your mortgage titled in, your cars, what your wishes are for children, if applicable. Those are really important first steps and to get a sense of where you are before you figure out where you want to go.
After the breakup, tell us more about what tends to happen as people try to get back on financial footing.
While most people don't have much of a roadmap, we've done a lot of work to put together one, a step-by-step guide that shows you what to expect around the next turn, how to build those support teams, links to find an attorney, a document checklist, tips on dealing with children, and how to rebuild your life after divorce. Most importantly for people, it's important to start small and chip away at it one step at a time. There will be another side to this, even if it gets really difficult at points along the way.
I would be curious to know, is there a difference between men and women and the time it takes them to recover financially?
I thought it was an interesting takeaway that for most men, the financial anxiety was most right before the divorce, and for most women, it's the most right after the divorce. So if you're someone who's at that point, know that it gets better. On the other side of that, then people do start to rebuild their personal lives, their financial lives, and 3/4 of people a few years out really feel like they have fully recovered.
Thank you, Meredith, and we certainly hope to have you back on the show again.
Thank you so much for the opportunity to talk to you. For more information, we encourage people to go to fidelity.com/lifeevents.
For more Business First AM, check us out on social media. We're on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. And go to businessfirstam.com for where to see our show on TV.